Presented by churchtechu.com, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to play a video only on the stage screen. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I help you learn all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. Before we get started, if you've ever run into a situation where someone said, okay, we can play a video on only the side screens or only the main screen or whatever, but how do we play it on only the stage screen? Go ahead and give me a thumbs up below. This is one of those things that people ask, well, why would you ever want to do it? And that's actually why this is kind of a little convoluted. Here's a situation I could think of. Imagine that you've got a children's service and you want the words up for the congregation to see, but you want the motions up for the leaders to see. So there's a video that has all the motions, you know, Jesus is my best friend or whatever they're doing, right? My wife's in children's ministry, so I've seen her do these things. I have no idea how to do it. But anyway, so how would you go about showing lyrics, maybe even with the motion background on the main screen, but also show on the stage screen this other video? Well, let's head over to my computer and we'll take a look. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to create a placeholder screen. Now, if you have another screen that's not doing anything, then that's perfectly fine. You can do that as well. But what I want to do is go to Screens and Configure Screens, and that's exactly what I've done. So this is one that I called Stage Screen Video, sorry about that, and it's a placeholder. So a placeholder screen is a screen that's not connected to anything. It just holds a place. So I created that. I think the original idea behind this was before there was live streaming in ProPresenter 7, you could have virtual screens at home while you're creating your presentations of whatever resolution you wanted. You know, let's say you have an LED wall at church and it's an odd resolution, then you could do this without having an LED wall at home, because that would be a little on the pricey side. So, all that to say, you could do this here with the stage screen video is what I called this placeholder screen. So you just click on the plus and then go down here to placeholder and select this. Coincidentally, I created a placeholder screen that's this guy over here to show multiple screens at once. So that's another reason why you might create a placeholder screen, is to have an operator screen that shows multiple things at once. I've got another tutorial on how to do that. I'll leave a link below the video. So we've got that. Now we need to go into Screens and Edit Looks. And we need a look. So notice I've got multiple presets because you can switch between presets. We need a look that is basically one that shows a prop but doesn't show anything above the props layer. And that's going to be our stage screen video. So remember, this is a placeholder screen, so it's not connected to anything right now. And I've only enabled the props here. I mean, there's other stuff underneath there, but it'll be covered up by the prop. Okay, so let's close that. And so what I could do is add a video on the props layer. Down here, I have a prop that I've created. I click the plus button here, and I went into the props editor and I added that on the editor. So dark blue video is the name of that. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to add an action to trigger that on this particular slide right here. So let's right click, add an action, props, dark blue video. So keeping in mind that the that won't go out on the main output. It will, that prop will only go out on the preview, this placeholder screen. But you might be wondering, how do I get the video from the placeholder screen to the actual stage screen? So let's again go into screens and edit layouts this time. And you want to click the little plus button to create a layout, which I've already done. Down here is one. I've called it video clip here. And if we, then I clicked on the big plus button here and I went to screen preview and I stretched it out to take up the entire screen. And down in this screen preview here, I want to select that stage screen video output that I created earlier. Just as well could have been any of these other outputs, but it is this stage screen video output. Notice it says it up here. That might be difficult for you to read depending on the resolution you're watching this at, but there it is. So this will show what is on the placeholder screen when I have this particular layout selected for the stage screen. So if I go to my stage screen, I've already selected that particular layout here, so that should be good to go. So it's now the case that, let's say I've got a, let's use this as a background. I've got that running. And then I click on this to trigger that video on the props layer. And right here, we should see this video that's on the props layer show up. And there it is. So what I've done is I'm basically playing two videos at the same time. I've got a background video. The reason why there's no background behind this is because I, in a previous tutorial, I turned that off. So if we go into screens, edit looks, and that's the main output. So I need to select that. See, there it is. So just to show you one more time, I'm going to go ahead and clear out all these. Okay, and also the prop. And let's click on the background and then click on this. That'll enable the prop, and that comes in right there. And this, you can imagine, is the motions for the leaders. And this is the song. Notice as I'm going through the song, this video keeps playing, as does this one. So that would be a great way to do this for the children's ministry at your church, if that's what you want to do. Or let's say there's an alternate version of the video that for some reason you want to show on the stage screen, you could do that as well. So either way, that's how to show a video on the stage screen only. Notice I don't have to have a background if I don't want to. So I could just have these, and this background video continues to play. And so if I had, if I clear all of this, notice it will trigger like that, and then you're good to go. So that is how to show a video on the stage screen only and not on the main screen. And as an aside, you can also still use video backgrounds for the main screen if you want. If you like this content, I bet you'd like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7quick, put in your name and email address, and then I will email you a login for that course. It's only 3 or 4 lessons. You can knock it out in a day, no problem, because, you know, they're like 10, 15 minutes each. Or if you want to space it out over time, that's cool too. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.